Hi there, in this video series, I'm going to show you how to use all of Elementor's free widget elements. It's the number one page builder for WordPress in the world, and you can get it by going to dualfox.com/Elementor. There you'll be able to download the free Elementor plugin. It's going to let you build a beautiful WordPress website, and I'm going to show you exactly how. So please do like the videos, subscribe to the channel, and now without any further ado, let's get straight to it and dive on in. In this video, we're going to have a look at the social icons element of Elementor, where you can design some really nice looking icons. So first thing we want to do is come on over to your search bar and type in social icons, grab the widget and drag it on into the page. Now by default, it gives you these three, Facebook, Twitter and YouTube, but you can change those just over here. So if you want to change one, click on it and then below it, you've got the icon, click into here. And now you've got a whole list of icons and you can also search for them up here. So if we wanted LinkedIn, start to type it, click on it, and then click on insert. And then that puts it into the page for you. When you've done that, put in the link up here. So you would simply go to a new tab, start typing in the website, find your particular profile, and then copy the URL and put that into here. And then when you've done that, you can click on the little link options cog. And you can choose whether you want it to open in a new window. I suggest that you do that. That way it will also keep your website open so people can come back to it at any time. And if you wanted, you could also make it a nofollow link. Although if you're linking to your own profiles, I wouldn't worry about that. It's no longer a big deal with SEO, so you can leave it as a follow link. And the other thing we can do is change the color. So just down here, it says official color. If I change this to custom, then what we can do is start changing the primary and secondary color. So if I choose green, we see it changes to green. And for secondary color, if I make it red, it's going to do that as well. Now we can do that for all of them at once in just a minute, but this is where you would be able to change them individually. But I don't like it, so I'm going to put it back to the official color. And then when we've done that, we can move on to Twitter or whatever the icon might be. Once again, grab your link, paste it in here, and do that for all three. Now, if there's one that you don't want that's already in the list, just click the little X and that'll get rid of it. And then if you want to add any more in, you've got a couple of options. Either come down here and click on Add Item and that'll insert it into the page for you. And once again, go in, choose the icon that you actually want, put in the link. Or what you can do is click the little copy button here and that will make a duplicate for you. And then you can obviously just go in and actually change that duplicate. So in this instance, I want to go with Instagram. And the other one I'm missing is Facebook. So I'm going to come up here, search for Facebook, put that into the page. And then if you want to reorder these, simply click and drag and you can change the order of them quite simply like that. So now I'm matching what I've got up there. And then just below that, we've got the actual shape. So when it's rounded, you've got the slight curve to the corners. If we go for square, those obviously become sharp corners. And you can go for a full-on circle as well if you want. And when you've done that, you can then choose the alignment. So we can have them on the left, the right, or in the middle. So once you've chosen the icons that you actually want, come on up to the Style tab. And here is where we can change them all at once. So instead of changing them individually, come under Color, go to Custom. And now when we choose a primary and a secondary color, you'll see that it's changing all of them at the same time. So if you want to do that, that's where you can. But I'm going to leave it as the official color. Size will obviously increase or decrease these. And then the padding, which is just below it, will increase the amount of space between the icon and the border. So if we increase this, we see that it's getting much larger, but the icons are being forced down in size. So I'm going to leave that as it was. Lastly, we have the spacing. So if we increase this, we'll get more space between the icons. And then we can actually alter the border type. So at the moment, there's no border here. If I change this, for example, to a solid border, the width option appears. So now we can start increasing this to put a border around it. And you can also unlink these values and change this. So if I unlink the values and put this back to 0 and this one to 0 as well, you see that we can start to create some odd looking shapes with this. So you can play around. And if you're wanting to do that, just remember to unlink the values. So now though, I'm going to take this down to around 5 pixels. And then what I want to do is change the color. So I don't want this gray. And you notice that when I'm hovering over it, it disappears. So bear that in mind, because what I want to do is change this to white, and I'm actually going to bring the opacity down and that'll make it transparent. So that way, whatever the page color is that you've got behind this, or whether you've got a picture behind it or anything, the border won't actually be seen now. And then we can come down to border radius. So at the moment, there's nothing there. If I put something in, automatically that takes that back to being a square. So this again is useful because we can increase this if you didn't want a full circle, but you wanted a little bit more than their normal curved options, you can do that. And once again, we can unlink it. So if I do that, we can now start to create different shapes. And if you combine that, obviously, with the board that I just showed you, you can make it look quite interesting. So when you've played around with it and got it how you want, just below you have icon hover. So when we do this, we can change the hover animation. So if I change this to shrink, when I hover over it, it gets smaller, or grow, and it gets bigger. So you've got a few options there in the list you can have a look through. I'm going to leave it on grow for now. And then we've got the border color. So this now is only when we're hovering over it. So if I change it to green, when I hover over it, we suddenly get that green border appearing. So that's why I made it transparent on the normal view, and now it's only appearing when we hover over it. So I'm just going to go for a light gray, and I'm going to bring the opacity down, and now it's just going to be quite light when we're hovering over. If we did want to put an image behind this as normal, come up to the actual section. You can then go to style, go to background, come into the classic section, choose an image, and we can put that behind. And as normal, we then just need to center it up, turn off the repeat, change the size to cover, and then come to the layout section, go to height, and obviously increase that up. But as I mentioned, as you can see, you can't see the border now unless we actually hover over it. So that's why it can be quite useful to make it transparent rather than just leaving it on white, because that would obviously only work when you actually have the white background. Now, the only other option is to have these vertically. So if we wanted to do that, I would come down here, create two rows or columns, and then come up to the widget toolbar. I'm going to go with an image. So let's put an image in here, make it the same one we have above. And then what we do is grab our social icons again, put the widget over here. And now we just want to do this slightly differently. Again, once you've chosen your links and everything like we did before, I'm going to go ahead and make these circles for this one, I think. Come up to style, and we can increase these in size. So let's go with 40, I think. And now what happens when I hover over here and start to drag this over, this will start to bring them down. So now what I want to do is come on over here to our column section of the widget, click on the column, and then I'm going to change the vertical align to middle, and I'm going to do the same for the horizontal. Now I'm going to come back to my actual widget, I'm going to bring the size up a little bit more, I think, maybe around 55, nope, let's go with 56 for now. We could obviously pull this across a bit more if we wanted, and then we could bring that down again. Now, the only problem here is if we wanted some space, if I start to change the spacing, it's still going to move it around from left to right. And the padding won't do it either, because all that's going to do is, once again, increase and decrease the space between the actual icon and the surrounding color there. So we'll leave that as it was. What I will do, though, is come on down to border, put in a solid border, increase that up to, let's say, around 10. I'm going to change the color over to white. And obviously we can change the border radius as we did before, curve it around and also change the shape of our icon. So again, if you want to make them this shape, exactly as we just looked at. And if you do want to move this around anymore, don't forget you can come over to the advanced tab and then we can go into the margins. And for example, if we unlinked this and start to move it around, that's going to move it around the page. Or we can also use the padding. And again, you just want to unlink that because if you leave it all in place, then it's going to start to make it behave weirdly. So bring that back to zero, unlink the values, and then let's say we increase the left one, that's going to move them all over close to the picture. So that gives you a little bit more control than just trying to do it here under the column settings and change the vertical alignment, because this is all very set. So, you know, you could sort of have them over here on the left, have them in the middle, have them in the right. But if you want to get somewhere in between, you're best off just using the padding up here under the advanced section of the actual widget. But there we go, really nice and simple one. And it's really easy to create these beautiful looking social icons with Elementor. You can also have them up here in the heading section as well if you want to. And I've got a separate video that explains how to create headings with Elementor, all that works in with your theme. So make sure to check that one out as well. But for now, I hope that's helped. If you have any questions, please post them on in the comments. And I look forward to seeing you on the next video.